If you want to become a GRC analyst or a blue team defender like a SOC analyst, you're going to need to understand how threat actors operate if you're going to have any chance of success. But how do you do that, right? How do you analyze the cyber threat landscape and know where to actually commit resources to drive cyber risk reduction? Well, by using cyber threat intelligence. Hi, I'm Dr. Gerald Osher at Simply Cyber. And even though I have 20 years of professional industry experience, I have got to keep leveling up my skills just like everybody else in the industry. And I just took the Cyber Threat Intelligence 101 course from Antysiphon, which was taught by Wade Wells. And in this video, I'm going to break down exactly what I learned in the course and whether or not you should consider taking the course as well. If you're looking to break into cybersecurity or looking to add cyber threat intelligence to your skill set, you won't want to miss this video. Let's go. Antysiphon Training hosts a ton of great cybersecurity learning opportunities. And I personally had the opportunity during their Incident Response Summit to take Cyber Threat Intelligence 101, which was taught by Wade Wells. Now, Wade is a great person and he has extensive experience specifically in cyber threat intelligence, which I'm going to refer to as CTI for the rest of this video. And he personally built this course to be hands-on and as accessible to students of every skill level. So if you are breaking into the industry, or if you're somebody who's old and gray like me, who's got 20 years of experience, there is value to be had and make it approachable for every skill level. I love it. The course is only one day long, which is perfect for me because I have a wicked busy schedule, and it's aligned to have a logical flow of the way that you would want to build your cyber threat intelligence knowledge, right? Like, here's some building blocks, here's at, you know, a macro 50,000 foot level, and then zeroing in into the actual life cycle of cyber threat intelligence. I'll get into that in a minute. Students are provided a bundle of resources before they even begin, so there's no like racing to make sure you have something or where'd you get that, right? You get this really great resource at the beginning. It includes 18 assets under the books, guide, and resources section, so there's a ton for you to dig into even after the course is over. There's workbooks to guide you through 6 practical labs, which Wade will set you up for success in the course, then you'll work on it on your own, and then reconvene as a group and go through the labs to make sure that you're actually understanding what you're learning. And if you have some challenges, Wade will make every effort to make it clear to you where you misstepped and make sure that you're learning the knowledge outcomes that you're supposed to be getting as a student. And of course, like every other Antysiphon training, you get the slides that are presented by the instructor. In this case, Wade had 8 different slide decks for his different segments of his course. Now, first things first, you will learn the different types of threat intel, and then you'll move into frameworks with focus given to cognitive bias after that, and more importantly, how to be self-aware of that. Then Wade gives into the intelligence lifecycle, which uses the knowledge that you learned already and organizes it for you to actually work or execute a lifecycle. So it's a very deliberate, very heady way that this course is organized. The tools are presented for getting your hands dirty after the life cycle, for collecting, for processing, for analyzing the intel that you're getting, basically enabling you to operationalize the intel life cycle that you just learned about in the previous section. And then you'll end with threat modeling, which is super, right? The labs throughout the course reinforced what was being taught in lecture and really made sure that, you know, you were, for me personally, learning it in kind of a different way. I like to learn through practice personally. So I heard his lecture, but then putting it in practice, I could see, oh yeah, like I actually don't understand this particular part, or this is how I would see it, and then get that immediate feedback from the instructor. It's cool. My version of the course leveraged Discord, so it was a, you know, remote course, as the medium for student engagement, and it allowed for really easy engagement for the instructor to deliver the lectures, for the students to coordinate and collaborate with each other, for the instructor to quickly see questions and get them answered right away. It had really, honestly, a similar vibe to in-person training, except I didn't have to stay in a hotel the night before and eat food that I really didn't want to, and then fly, which I wouldn't want to. So while the entire course assumes no prerequisites, it really does cover fundamental scope of CTI. Now, obviously, I have experience doing some CTI, doing GRC, doing Blue. So I certainly have a different perspective than other students potentially. But I did feel that there was nothing that I was like, oh, good thing I knew about that so I could understand what Wade's saying. He really does start at the ground level, clear a nice space, and then build a foundation on which the students learn. A couple aspects I thought that were noteworthy that I wanted to share with you were the tools section and the case study section Wade used to help the students learn. Now, again, there is, 8 hours of content in this course. So I'm just cherry picking a few that I particularly liked. The tools he presented are readily available. And I personally found myself searching for threat intel on assets that I am personally responsible for defending and protecting, you know, in my normal day-to-day work. If I had some time in between lectures or I finished my lab work early, I was on those tools searching. And I actually found some interesting things. I posted a short over on my YouTube channel about one of the tools, dnstwist.it, that I found. Go check that out. But the takeaway here is, as a student, as a typical student, I was getting immediate value from the course, like actionable value that I could leverage and immediately start driving risk reduction for the business I'm responsible for protecting. I absolutely loved it. And even if you don't take the course, I'd encourage you to go check out the dnstwist.it site that I mentioned. I thought it was really cool. It basically searches on domains that have similar names, like domain squatting, and it discovers, basically sussy domains and points you to them. So you can basically get a list of potential threats and go investigate them. It's super, super cool. Another really cool education technique employed by the instructor was using Jurassic Park as a case study. Yes, the actual original OG Jurassic Park, John Hammond, the Jurassic Park John Hammond, spare no expense, making dinosaurs out of, DNA, right? He uses it. He allows students who, Jurassic Park is very familiar, right? So he asked students to collaborate in this workshop segment to talk through, okay, what are the threats at Jurassic Park? What should they have been thinking about? What intel could they pull in? Include assets like the people at Jurassic Park, the intellectual property, right? The science behind it, the environmental aspects of it. Obviously, there's dinosaurs. There's insider threats like Newman, or whatever his name was in this movie. Physical threats, like if the fences fail, a dinosaur could eat you. And then how to gather that threat intel, analyze it, and make it actionable. So he literally took something that's, nostalgic and familiar to many of us, or at least you can wrap your head around a dinosaur island theme park, and applied it directly to the lessons that we had learned just previously in the class. It was a really interesting technique, and I found it incredibly effective. An aspect of the course that was not part of the overall curriculum, so you wouldn't know this was coming, and honestly, I think it was low-key the most valuable part of taking the class, was this massive list of resources and tools that were dropped during the course. Some were pre-planned resources, right? They're like in his slide decks and stuff, but the instructor, Wade, he would regularly share like relevant personal stories from his job, because he does cyber threat intelligence for a living, and he would be reminded of a tool and where it came in, and he'd quickly pull it up, or like a GitHub repo or something, he'd pull it up and he'd share it with the class. And I'm telling you, I personally have like 15 resources that I didn't know about prior to this class in a list of my notes that I'm going to go back and investigate and realize and see where I can get value from it. But I know it's got value because he showed me in the class that it's got value. Like, this class sounds fun, right? But like, why would someone want to take a cyber threat intelligence class? Cyber threat intelligence will allow you, whether you're GRC, blue team, whatever, to be proactive with your security posture. You can look, go threat hunting and say, hey, do we have an issue in this space? They go through MITRE ATT&CK quite a bit in the CTI course. So you can go get TTPs. You can learn about indicators of compromise or IOCs. You can say, all right, we're going to go and make sure that we're secure from these type of threats or these type of attack techniques or whatever, these type of threats, before they actually get here and try to exploit our weaknesses. We can make sure that we're tough, right? Because at the end of the day, guys, it's super easy to put controls in place, but if you're not making sure they're informed by active threats that are threatening your business, your organization, your industry, whatever, then you're kind of hoping that you're choosing the right threats to protect from, right? And as a GRC person, you only got so much money and so much time to put risk reduction in place. So wouldn't you want it to be, actually more informed. That's what cyber threat intel does. Plus, you can do faster incident response, faster threat mitigation. If you know what the threats are, what their habits are, where they're going, what assets are important to them, there's real world applications of CTI that you can use, right? You can identify potential threats that would target your specific manufacturing mid-size organization because there's intel from MITRE ATT&CK or from different industry resources, maybe an ISAC that says, hey, there's an uptick in activity. Dude, threat actors recently went crazy on healthcare. Would have been good to know that in advance, right? You know, for me personally, I found this course informative. I found it well-structured. As an educator myself, I definitely appreciate the preparation and the way that the instructor came ready and, you know, smart with the way he delivered the content, the way he handled the students. I don't know about any of the other students, but I certainly got mad value from it. It was a $295 course. You know, to me, that is a reasonable price point. If you could get, I think it'd be a pretty easy sell to get your business to send you to take a $295 course. I personally paid for it myself, but I understand that different people's financial situations is different for everybody, and $295 might be something that you can live on for a month. I know in college, I would have lost my mind if I was given $295 because I could have lived for a semester. So I get it. I'm just telling you what the price is, all right? If you work in the industry, if you want to get into cyber threat intelligence, which is its own role altogether, although I see it as value on being able to do GRC work or SecOps work more effectively, this course is a wonderful introduction, an inch deep, a mile wide. It gives you the whole life cycle. It gives you a ton of tools. It gives you a boatload of follow-on work so you can take this as far as you want. I loved it. I recommend it. I strongly encourage. I'll put a link below. I'm not affiliated. I'm not getting kickbacks or whatever from Wade. I'm not getting In-N-Out burgers from him. You get an extra, you know, large fry, Jerry, if you send students. I literally just enjoyed this course and I enjoy what Antysiphon's doing and I wanted you to know about it. So if you're interested in content like this, especially GRC content, check out the rest of the videos on my Simply Cyber YouTube channel. But if you want to see another course I took from Antysiphon that was bananas, taught by John Strand, check out that video popping up right there on active defense and cyber deception. It's absolutely sick. See you in the next one.